of this missionary class. Thank you so much for being so kind and loving through of all these days, O Lord, through the pandemic times, through the lockdown, and now, Lord, even as Lord, everybody is so eager to learn about you, about your children. Lord, will you give us a heart? Will you give us a desire to learn, Lord, to know, and Lord, to have you in our hearts? Be with us. Let your spirit lead us, O Lord. You talk to us. And please guide us. Be with each one of us. I commit Abigail, Emanuela, Nathan, Samuel, and Lord Seth, and Phinehas, and Josh, and Joanna, Joel, and all of them, Lord, who are present this afternoon. Be with us, and please speak to us. In Jesus' name, we all pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay. Hello, everybody. Hi. Right. I'm sure you all are happy this morning, and I think you all are done with your goals. Did you?
Yep. Everyone put a green dot.
Yes, ma'am.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful, and I congratulate everybody for going up another level. I'm guessing, is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, because you were just done with graduation and all that, right? Okay. Yes, all right. So it's so nice to see all of you, Phinehas and Abigail, Emanuela, and Josh, and Sarah, and all of you. Joel. Hello, Joel. And who is this here? Is that Ruth? Oh, no. What's her name again?
Bensi Rajant. Priscilla.
Priscilla. Okay. Hello, Priscilla. Okay. Hello, everybody. I know I think I'm a little in the darkness, but I just hope that you can still see me. And I hope that you will follow this class. Okay? All right, I hope.
Class, something about darkness.
Yeah, let's go and see. Okay. All right, guys. So very quickly, I don't want to revise anything that we learned the last time, but I just want to begin a new missionary story. And so are you all happy this morning?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So if that is the case, can you just repeat these words after me? Okay. Tell these words. Psalm.
Psalm.
107.
107.
You say 107.
107.
9. 9.
Okay, everybody say it together and say it fast. Okay, Psalm 107, 9.
Psalm 107, 9.
For he satisfies.
The
longing soul.
The longing soul.
And fills the hungry soul.
And that fills the hungry soul.
With goodness.
Okay,
see that after me.
For he satisfies.
Longing soul.
And fills the hungry soul.
With goodness. Look at this verse, everybody. I want you to memorize it, okay? Last two more times, we'll just say that and you can repeat it after me.
Psalm 107, 9.
And fills the hungry soul with goodness.
With goodness.
Can I tell you?
Okay. You want to try? Please try. Yeah.
He satisfies the longing soul and fills the hungry soul with goodness.
Even I got it.
Clap hands for her. You did a great job. All right. Anybody else wants to try?
I want to try, ma'am.
Okay. You want to try? Sarah, you want to try?
Yes.
Okay. Please go ahead.
For he satisfies.
Yeah.
Longing soul.
That's right.
The hungry soul with goodness.
Me, ma'am. Me.
Okay. Go on. Try.
Psalm 107, 9.
for he. Nothing.
Okay, okay, no worries. Okay, guys, all of you, maybe just
ma'am, can I say it?
Okay, Finehas, try.
For he satisfies the longing soul and fills the hungry soul with goodness.
Good job. That's wonderful.
Psalm 179.
That's wonderful. Josh, you want to try?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
he satisfies the longing soul and fills the hungry soul with goodness.
Wonderful.
A wonderful environment.
Psalm 107, verse 9.
That's right. Wonderful. Can we all clap hands for Josh again? Okay. All right, guys. One last time. We will all say it together. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Psalm
107, verse 9.
He satisfies
the longing soul.
Yeah, the longing soul.
And her hungry soul with goodness.
Yes. Psalm
107, verse 9.
Okay. You did a great job, everybody. Can you clap hands? Yay, you did a great job. And those who are feeling sleepy, can you just wide open your eyes like that? Like, can you open them up? Okay, don't drag, Nehas. Your spectacles might break. Okay, everybody. So I hope you all are happy this morning. So very quickly, we'll go into our lesson and see what God has in store for us. Ready? Can you say yes?
Yes.
Anything, it's your choice. Okay, anything. I'm so happy and excited to see all of you after a long time. All right, Joel, are you here? Do you look to me? Yeah. Are you good? Are you doing fine?
Yeah.
Okay. So, are you listening to us? Okay. Good. Joel, please listen. Okay. Yeah, all of you, I request you all to pay attention when I'm speaking, okay? Seth, are you there, Seth? Seth, are you there? Can I see your face? Okay. Priscilla?
Yes?
Hello, Priscilla. Can you just wave your hand at me? Oh, good job. Thank you. All right, Finehas, if you can stop beating your head, then we can proceed. All right, guys. So this is a wonderful thing. And I request all of you to repeat these words after me, okay? Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
As we pray.
Father, we pray.
Father, we pray.
That you be with us. And that you would speak to us. Through this missionary.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. I just want to start off. Okay. There was a little boy who was born in a wealthy family. Okay. And then the best part about this little boy was that he was not a believer. He was not born in a Christian family. He was born in some other family. And you want to know about which person we are going to talk today, from which country he is born, from which family he is, what language he speaks, what's the kind of way he dresses. You know that? I'll tell you. In the year 1889, remember that, okay? 1889, there was a little boy born to a wealthy family, okay? And his name is Sundar Singh. Can you tell that?
Sundar Singh.
That's right. That's
Sundar Singh.
That's Punjabi, ma'am.
Pardon me?
He's Punjabi.
That's right. So I'm sure most of you all have a glimpse of this story already.
Yes,
but I want you to pay close attention. What you might know today is something that you never heard before. Okay.
So Adu Sundar Singh.
Ah, that's right, Seth. Thank you so much. Okay. So pay close attention and everybody, shh, silently listen, okay? And so this Sadhu Sundar Singh, he was born, like the name says, Singh, no? It means that he was born in a Sikh family, okay? It means not that they were all Sikh and not that kind of Sikh, but S-I-K-H. Sikh is a community of people, okay? And they are all a different community in India, okay? And in the state called Punjab, in a place called Rampur, okay? He was born in Rampur in Punjab in the year 1889. So Sundar Singh was born in a Sikh family. And basically, you know, how do you identify Sikhs when you go on the road and when you walk? And if suddenly you have to recognize somebody who's a Sikh, how do you know it?
They will have that...
Yeah, any
clue? Turban.
That's right. That's right. They have something strange on their heads, okay? And that's called a turban, okay? It's nicely, you know, it is nicely set up on the head along with, they have a lot of hair and then they don't shave their head, okay? Like they don't even go for a haircut. All the Sikh men, they grow their hair long, like you know. And then
they will put some kind of a thing.
That's right, Josh. They plait, they plait their hair, they braid their hair, and then they put up that knot and that turban, okay? So that's called a turban. And that is how you recognize who a Sikh person is and who is not, right? Okay, so that's about the Sikh family. And Sundar Singh, he was born in this wealthy family. And then, you know what? His mom, he had a loving mother, okay? Like everybody else, he had mom, dad, and then, you know, parents, siblings and all of that. He had a loving mother, and that mama would love Sadhu Sundar Singh so much, that she would wake him up in the morning. Hey, you, wake up. Guess at what time? Not at 7 o'clock, not at 8 o'clock, not even at 6 o'clock. Very early in the morning, like before 5 o'clock, she would wake him up. And then, you know what she would do? Each one of us, we wake up at just before school, and then we quickly brush and get ourselves freshen up. And then again, somebody should give us breakfast, or we might even eat in the snack break. I know that. And then that's how it is, right? But you know, Sundar Singh's mom, she never even gave him breakfast if he did not say his prayers. So he is supposed to wake up early in the morning, like while it is still so cold and, you know, that dark, and he wakes up, he takes a bath. Okay, can you imagine getting up so early and taking a bath? He would take bath and then he would do his prayers, and only then his mom would give him breakfast. Do you think all our moms should apply the same rule for all of us?
Never.
I will definitely message Jacinth ma'am about this, that this rule might be implemented in all of your houses. Okay, children. But my point here is not that I want to trouble you or anything like that, but the kind of desire they have, you know, the kind of devotion they have to, you know, say their prayers, even though they were not believing on the true God, right? Right, Emmanuela? Right? Okay. And so that is how it was. I hope you all are able to listen to me, right? Yeah. Can I see a thumbs up from everybody? A thumbs up? Thank you so much. Joel? Yeah. Thank you so much, Priscilla. Thank you, everybody. So let's just quickly move on. Okay. So that was it is. And then while he was a very young kid, okay, maybe like all of you, he had a great desire in his heart. Okay. Sundar Singh had a great desire to know more about God. So he would always, you know, go to different kind of temples with his mama and then, you know, go there and do different kinds of prayers. And have you ever seen a Gurudwara, anybody here? No, but it's okay if you don't see. Maybe the next time I will share screen with you all and show you the different types of images, okay? I will show you the pictures of all of that. I will even show you the picture of Sundar Singh. We want to know how he looks like, right? Okay, so let us see how smart and handsome he was. But all of that happened. So his mama would take him to different temples and he would pray with her. But the one thing is, and she always taught him three things. She always told him, Sundar, you always need to be holy. You have to lead a holy life. You should not do anything that is wrong and evil. You should not do anything which is wrong, which is bad. Okay, let me ask you a simple question. Do we all know what is good and what is bad? Can I just see thumbs up? Okay, thumbs ups, guys. Do you know what's good and what's bad? Everybody, good job. Okay, let me ask you simple questions. Okay, and I'll ask you a question and you say if it is a good or if it is bad, okay? Thumbs up is good and thumbs down is bad, okay? Got that? Smile, everybody, please. Can I see smiling faces? Okay, so that shows you all are attentive. I love your face, Josh, with the smiling face. Anyways, okay, here we go. Let me ask you a question. Disobeying parents, is it good or bad? Good job, good job. Everybody, everybody. All right, the next question. Going out somewhere without your parents' notice, is it good or bad? Okay. All right. Is praying good or bad? Praying, good. Not praying is bad. Okay. What about reading the Bible? Is it good or bad? Good. Not reading the Bible? Not reading the Bible. Okay, it's bad. How about stealing something? It's bad. Very good. Very good. How about beating your brother? Beating him up nicely, your brother or your sister? When you are irritated and like, and he's going, Joel, is it good or bad? It's bad. Very good, children. You all did an excellent job. Okay, that's
for
enough.
For that, I've taught, did like this.
Okay, I will see that and we will talk about it. Anyways, so we all know what's good and what's bad, right, children? Absolutely, we all know that, right? Okay, and so his mom always encouraged him to be good and not never to be bad. And then she always told him to have compassion for the poor people, for the suffering people. Okay, yeah, all right. So that's how he was being brought up in the family. And then very soon he used to go to the school and he would go and ask the teachers, okay, listen up guys, I have so many doubts, okay? We have doubts sometimes, right? I don't know, there'll be always a person in the class who has the most number of doubts and for everything they'll be like, ma'am, what about this? Ma'am, what about that? Ma'am. Okay, and so Sundar was like that. He was so curious. He wanted to know so many things more about God. And he would go to his teachers and ask, teacher, sir, sir, ma'am, could you please tell me what happens? What is all this? How did I, what's all this about? What's my life? What's going to happen when I die? Or tell me more about God. Who is he? What is he like? Or how do I get to him? He would ask questions like this. And those teachers were so fed up with Sundar, because they could not even answer all of his questions. And so you know what they would say? They would say, okay, Sundar, you know something? When you grow up, you will know all the answers. For everything, they would just tell, when you grow up, you will know all the answers. When you grow up, but Sundar was never satisfied with those answers. He used to think, okay, these people are saying when I grow up, I will know the answers. What if I die when I'm young? What if I die when I'm only in the school? Then what? If I don't know about my creator, where will I go? He was always being bothered with all of these questions. So remember that Sundar had a great desire to know about God. My question to all of you this morning, children, do we have the desire to know about God? We also need to have the desire that Sundar had to know about God. And so one day, I'll tell you something, okay? One day, this is a cool thing. Everybody do like this. Okay, it's like as if you have mustache and then you're doing like that, okay? Yeah, Sundar Singh's father, he was a big man. And you know what his name is? His name is Sardar Sher Singh. What is his name?
Sardar Sher Singh.
Ah, Sher Singh means, share means, what is it in, what's it in English? What's share?
To share or to give something, whatever.
No, it's not English share, Josh. Share is a Hindi Punjabi word which means a lion. Okay, what is it? A lion. Share. So that's what his name is. His name is Sher Singh. So it's like the mighty name. Right? Okay. So he was, the man was also like that. Sundar's father was also like that. Very strict.
Ma'am.
Yes, please.
Is it Lion Singh?
it's something like that. It's something like that. Okay. So everybody remember his father's name is Sardar Sher Singh. Okay. So this Sardar Sher Singh was a disciplined man. He was a very strict person and all of that. And so one day, just like all of our parents, he asked Sundar to come close and he gave him few coins. Okay. few coins. That means few money. Okay, maybe, I don't know, it was 1 rupee coins, 2 rupee coins, 5 rupee coins. He gave him some money and he said, but back in those days, there were, you know something, children, not 1 rupee, 2 rupee. There was even lesser coins like paise and NPs, even lesser. Okay, whatever it is. He just gave him some money and he said, hey, Sundar, tum jao, jaake kuch khareedo. Khane ke liye kuch khareedo, go buy something and eat. So he gave him some money, okay? And then who was that? Dada gave him. Sardar Sher Singh gave Sundar Singh some coins to go and buy some sweets. So while he was holding those coins, oh, he was imagining his favorite sweet. His mouth was watering, just like you're remembering your favorite sweet now, whatever it is, kaddu ka kheer or gulab jamun or I don't know, yummy food, right? So he was remembering. And then he was walking out and suddenly he saw a poor old lady there, like a beggar. And she was like stretching her hand, babu, de do, something like that. She was begging, could you please give me something? Oh, I'm here in this road, nobody to give anything. And the moment Sundar saw her, the lady, he was moved with so much compassion. He thought, Are, poor man, poor thing, this old lady. She doesn't have anything to eat. She's lying on the road here. It's so cold and it is things like that. Okay, so let me give her something, he thought. And you know what he did? All the money that his dada gave him, he gave it off to her. And he slowly went back home. He went back home. And after he went back home, did he show his sweet to his daddy? No, he quietly went back home and his father was there sitting and he said, Daddy, Daddy, listen up. I need you to do something. I saw a poor old lady out there on the street. Would you please do something for her? Would you please buy her a blanket? Because it's very cold out there. She doesn't even have anything to cover herself. Will she die like that? Will she starve and die like that? His father was refusing. Hey, what is this man? Sundar Singh, you're irritating me. We've helped that old lady so many times, no? Always she keeps coming and she keeps begging. There'll be some people, no, like that around our vicinity. They'll always keep coming and they'll always keep begging. And, you know, and then when we give them something sometimes, but, you know, sometimes people might get irritated. Aray, she keeps coming every day. We'll give her something or the other. You know, we take them casually.
If we give them one time, they will come again and again every day.
That's right, Josh. This poor beggar lady was also like that. But Sundar Singh's heart was so kind. Sundar Singh's heart was so kind that he wanted to help her in any way. And so, you know what he did? As he went in, he asked father, Sardar Sher Singh, Daddy, Daddy, please, I want to help her. So why don't you give her a blanket? You know his response? Hey, what is this? You always keep helping her? You mind your work. Enough is enough. Somebody else will help her this time. You shut up and sit down. Something like that. He was very angry and annoyed with him. You know what Sundar did? You think he gave up? No, children. You know what Sundar Singh did? He quietly went into his daddy's room. And there was a coat hanging on the wall. And he slowly tiptoed into the room and tried to put his hand in the coat's pocket. And he found something. Slowly he took it out. And went. And you know what he did? Gave that money to the old lady. And quietly, he came back again. And like everybody else, he sat. His father checked his coat and he found money missing. So he called all his siblings. Okay, Sundar and his brothers and everybody were there. Hey, did you take my money from the coat? No, Papa, why would I take? It's not me. And then you, did you take? No, Papa, it is not me. Sundar's turn came and he asked, Sundar, did you take? No, Papa, it is not me. He said, and his father believed and his father left. And that night, he was sleeping. But what did he do? First thing, he robbed from his dad's pocket. Second thing, he lied to his dada that he did not steal the money. So he couldn't sleep. He was feeling so restless. He's just tossing and turning on his bed. You know, sometimes when we are not sleepy, but we are forced to put to sleep, that time we are not sleepy, but we keep tossing and turning and this side and that side. He was turning and, you know, and then when he was doing that, he thought, okay, I cannot sleep like this. I'd have no peace in my heart. What I did is bad. He felt guilty in his heart. And you know what he thought? Next morning, he decided, okay, whatever it is going to be, I'm going to go and tell my father what I did. So immediately he woke up in the morning and then, you know, he bathed himself and he rushed into his father's room, just so scared and terrified, because he knew if he tell the truth, he would get a punishment from his father, right? Yes, is it that? Can I see thumbs ups, everybody? Priscilla, Joel, and Sarah. Yeah, very good. Okay, so if he told the truth, he was sure that he would get a punishment. But then he went slowly into his father's room and he's like, Daddy, Papa, I want to tell you something. He's like, what is it? Tell me. He said, yesterday, there were lost money in your pocket. You lost some money. And I am the one who robbed it, because I wanted to help that poor lady. I'm sorry, Papa, will you forgive me? And you know what happened? Sardar Sher Singh, he took a big stick and he didn't beat him. He just hugged his son Sundar and he said, it's okay, my boy. I know you that, and I know that you are honest. I'm glad that you told me the truth. And he hugged him and he forgave him. Isn't that wonderful? And then, you know what, to make him happy, he said, okay, I promise you that I will buy a blanket to the old beggar lady outside. And so they were so happy because his father promised him, okay. And then again, he gave him some more money and he said, go buy your favorite sweet. And this time he took the money and bought his favorite sweet to eat. Isn't that wonderful, everybody? So I will quickly tell one last thing before we close this, our class, missionary class. Okay, this is called, he was studying in a school. Okay, what is the name of your school? Seth, tell me, what's the name of your school? Hello,
Mr. Grace Tabernacle Learning Center.
That's right, Grace Tabernacle Learning Center. Okay, very good. Okay, and what is the curriculum you follow?
ACE.
Very good, ACE. Good job. And Joel, can you tell me the name of your ma'am? Quickly. Oh no.
Deba ma'am.
Uh-huh. Any one ma'am. Okay, but the main ma'am. Okay, I don't know what you call them. Supervisors or?
Supervisors.
Okay.
Ruth ma'am, Joel's ma'am's name is Sheba.
Okay, Sheba. All right.
Deba ma'am.
Thank you so much. So just like you all have, you know, you are all studying in this institution. Sundar Singh was studying in a school called American Presbyterian Mission. Can you say that?
American Presbyterian Mission.
It's not Presbyterian, sorry. It's Presbyterian.
Presbyterian Mission.
Yeah, remember, this is going to be the last incident I want to share. Okay, so listen closely. American Presbyterian Mission. And in this school, you know, they would teach nice, you know, they were the missionaries who established these schools. And so all these people, you know, from Hindu community, from Muslim community, from Sikh community, all the wealthy, like the rich kids, they all used to join the school. Okay? Seth, are you listening? Yeah, all of these people would join in this school. But you know what? They did not like that they used to teach Bible in these schools, because they were mission schools. The teachers would teach them also about Bible and, you know, the God of the Bible and all of that. But these people didn't like. So, you know, one day, Sundar didn't really like Christians. He didn't really like Bible. He was very irritated. He used to think, "Are, what is this? This is India, and what is that? We have many religions, and what else? We have our own religions." Sikh people, you know what they read? They call that book called as Guru Granth. Okay, they have a book named Guru Granth. So we read all that. Why are these mad people giving me Bible? I don't even like it. See, he used to hate Christians. He used to hate the Bibles and all that. And one day, he was so annoyed that, you know, he was given a Bible. Okay. He was given
a Bible. I know what he did.
Me too.
Okay. I won't tell that. Quiet, everybody. I'll tell that later. Once what happened, okay, keep that in your mind. I'll ask you what he did, okay? And then when somebody would, you know, preach on the streets and tell about Jesus, you know what he would do? He would slowly go take some stones and then just pelt them. Okay, he would just throw the stones on their heads or, you know, things like that and disturb them. Throw stones at them and disturb the whole thing. And if in the class somebody were coming and taking Bible classes, he would hate them. He would ask them all awkward and, you know, criticizing questions and make fun and disturb everybody. And he would never listen to the class. And once when he was given a New Testament, he was so irritated. He came out of the class. He tore all the pages of the Bible and he threw it in the fire. And everybody knew what is happening with Sundar Singh. Why is he being so mad? Why does he hate Christ so much? Why does he hate the Bible so much?
Because they are Muslims.
No, sir, they are Sikhs. They are not Muslims. They are Sikhs.
What are Sikhs?
That's Sikh? What I'm saying. Sikh is another community.
Okay? They're not Muslims.
Okay, so listen up, guys. Okay, the ones who understand, I think you should pay close attention. Okay, and so that was about it. But then, you know, his father came to know. They called up his father and they told him, see, this is how your son was misbehaving. And then his father was very angry, Sardar Sher Singh, that he came and he said, Sundar, what is it that you did? You cannot just burn anybody's holy books. See, everybody's got their own holy books and why should you have to burn them? So he was very angry at his misbehavior. Then Sundar was even more annoyed because he thought, "Arre, what is this? Even Papa is not supporting me. What I did is right, no? Then why is he not supporting me?" But he was so irritated and he had so much grudge for all Christians. And slowly, slowly, he was 14 years old. And during this time, you know, children, something sad happened in Sundar Singh's life.
His mother died.
No, that's not what happened. Two people in his family, one after another, they died. Yeah. That's right. What you said was right. His mama passed away and very soon his brother passed away. The mama was one of his most loved person in the family. She passed away. She died. And the very next person that he was so close to was
his brother.
And his brother also died. And he was so, you know, he was so sad and full of sorrow. He was feeling so bad. What is this? Why did this happen to me? I lost all of them. And during this time, children, you know what happened? He was so frustrated that he would take out all his frustration on Christians. Whenever he found a Christian teacher or whenever he heard something in the Bible class, he would make fun of them, criticize them and all that. But you know what? He always had this in his heart and in his mind. And he thought, okay, if I need to know what God is like, what is the truth? I need to know, am I following the truth? Or is there something else which is called the truth? He was so frustrated. He was deeply hurt. Okay. So when you're feeling sad, let me ask you something. What do you do? Sometimes you will keep quiet. Sometimes you will cry. Sometimes you bang the door of your room. Sometimes you don't let anybody come inside. Sometimes you don't feel like talking to anybody. Like, I'm not talking to anybody. Please leave me alone. You know, we feel like that. And Sundar Singh also felt so hurt in his heart. He prayed and he thought, okay, God, whoever you are, if you will not tell me what the true way is today, I am going to kill myself. Is that a good thing?
He's going to kill himself, but when the train is going to come under,
he will fall on the rail. He will...
All right, since you know all of that, I will cut it short. He planned to kill himself. But then that particular night he slept. And early in the morning at 3 a.m. Will you get up at 3 a.m.? We will all be like... we will all be like sleeping at 3 a.m. in the morning. But this Sundar, he had a desire. I told you, no? He wanted to know at any cost. I want to know who the God is. I want to know what the true way is. And so he wakes up at 3 a.m. in the morning and he's kneeling down there. He took a shower. He came back. It's everything is dark outside. Everything is quiet inside. Nobody is there. The people are sleeping everywhere. It's quiet. And he is in his room crying and crying and weeping and tears are rolling down his eyes. He's hurt, he's frustrated, he wants to know who God is, and he's crying out to him and saying, Lord, if I do not know, if I don't see you today, if I will not know who, which is the right way today, I am going to take my life. Please help me, please talk to me. He was crying and praying. 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, no sign. He was so disappointed and he was crying and crying. But then before the sun came, while it was still dark, there was a kind of dim light that was coming into his room. He didn't understand, Are, from where is this light coming in? I wonder from where is this light? He thought maybe there were some lights that were glowing outside. So he opened the door, he went out and he checked. There were no lights on. He came inside, the light grew bigger and bigger and brighter, and it formed in a shape of a globe. There was a light shining in the form of a globe, and then he saw Jesus. He saw Jesus, and Jesus said, Sundar Singh, why do you persecute me? See, I have died for you on the cross and for whole mankind, for all the world. And this is what he saw. And gradually, everything became normal. He stopped crying when he saw Jesus. He had a great calm, a great peace in his heart. He was so full of joy, indescribable peace. He was thanking the Lord so much. And he said, Lord, thank you for what you have done today. I believe you with all my heart. Forgive me of my sin. I will be your follower. And you know what happened, children? Just imagine if something like that happens to us, we'll be like, oh. But remember, children, we don't need to expect things like that in our lives. Why? Because Jesus already gave us Bible. And when we read it, he speaks to us just like he spoke to Sundar Singh. But for Sundar Singh, he did not know anything about Jesus and he was desperate to know. That is why maybe Jesus appeared to him. Isn't that wonderful? So very quickly the sun rose and then he ran into his father's room and he was knocking, knock, 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 knock. Okay, father, papa, open up, open up. And his father was like, what is it, my son? What woke you up so early? What's the matter with you? And he says, Daddy, you know something? I saw Jesus this morning. He gave me a lot of peace in my heart. His father was like, Sardar Sher Singh was like, ye kya ho gaya isko? Is he mad? The other day he was tearing Bibles and burning them off and, you know, beating people with stones, other Christian people and all. And today he's saying, I saw Jesus. I love him. I believe. I think he's gone mad. He thought he's insane. And he said, I think you must have seen some kind of a dream. Just go back to sleep and just lie down for some time. And then his father didn't believe him in the beginning. But as the days went by and by and by, you know, after he saw Jesus, he started to believe. He went to the school and, you know, the headmaster of the school was very close to him because headmaster was his friend's father. Okay, his friend's name was Siridhar. I think something like that. Okay. His friend's name was Siridhar. Okay. And so this friend and also Sundar, they both went to him and like, could you please teach us about Jesus? Could you please teach us something from the Bible? Please, sir, we want to learn from the Bible. The headmaster was so scared. Is your headmaster scared to tell you about Bible? No, right? Are your supervisors afraid to teach you about Jesus?
No.
Right? Do we have the freedom to learn about his word? Yes. Yes. But back then, they were so terrified because, oh my, if their parents come to know that these people are learning about Jesus, they will make sure that the school is closed down because they will think that we are forcefully teaching the children something and we are manipulating them, converting them. So the headmaster was scared. But then Sundar Singh insisted, no, sir, please, we want to learn. Teach us what it says from the Bible. And that's how we started learning more of the Bible. As the days went by and by and by, you know what? People in his family came to know that he accepted Jesus as his savior. And then nobody were, you know, everybody were so angry. So you know what they did? The friend's parents, you know, the friend's parents, they filed a case against the people in the school. And in the court, imagine, have you ever seen a court, children? A high court. Okay, it's like a place where, you know, there are judgments, there are cases that are being that will be put forward, and then, you know, the judge will tell who's right, who's wrong. Okay, and whoever is wrong, they will give them the punishment, and whoever is right, they will let them go free and not guilty. Okay, it's like that. I'll show you all these pictures. So I'll tell this part and close. Okay, so they were put forward in the court, and even in the court, Sundar and his friend, the judge asked him, hey, you tell us, boys, what are they? Are they telling the truth? Are they forcibly asking you to learn about Bible and learn about Jesus? Then the boldly student said, no, sir, no. It is us. We know it from the Bible that Jesus is true, and that he loves us so much, that he died for us on the cross, and that he rose again on the third day. That is why we believe him. Nobody forced us. And at this point, everybody, you know, they were all so upset. Sundar's parents and, you know, that Siridhar's parents, they were all upset. And they said, you get out of our home, you don't even come back. But then they gave them some more time. So Sundar came back home. And you know what he did? As he read his Bible again and again, he understood that he needs to follow Jesus. So one day he went out and came in. The moment he came inside, Sardar Sher Singh saw some great change in Sundar. What have you done to yourself? What did you do? Where is your turban? Where is your hair? Sundar cut his hair, took off the turban. And Sundar Singh's father was greatly annoyed. And he said, if this is what you could do, you disgraced our family, you disgraced our community, please, I beg of you, leave this Jesus, leave this Christianity. And you know what he did? He took him to his uncle's home. At his uncle's home, that uncle took him into a room, secret room, and he opened a big box. What was in the box? You know, children, there was a big box that was opened in Joel. You might love what was in the box, Priscilla. You know, because what was in the box was so many jewels, nice pearls, lots of money. Wow, we would be like, wow, uncle, thank you so much. And then we would take all of that. And then you know what the uncle said? Sundar Singh, if you will leave this God, if you will leave this Bible, I will give all of this to you. You are from a wealthy family. You can do wonderful in your life. But what did Sundar do? He did not give in. Though he was a little boy, imagine, children, he was just 15 years old. Just 15, 14, 15 years old. But he said, no, uncle. No, uncle, I'm sorry. I cannot take that. I want Jesus. And then he was cast out from his home. And his father said, all right, if this is going to be your decision, get out of my house and never again come back. Sundar took his small New Testament Bible in his hand. And as he was going out, you think he was crying? My papa left me. Everybody is asking me to go away. Where should I go now? He didn't even cry. You know, it's written that in his story, he went out and he sat under a tree the whole day until night. And it says that he had peace in his heart. Though everybody left him, he had peace in his heart. Now, with this, I will close. And from far, he saw one lady from his house, his sister-in-law. Okay? She looked at Sundar from afar And she silently, secretly, without anybody noticing, she waved his hand to Sundar. And she was like, everybody look at me, guys. Okay? And you have to guess what she told. She waved hand and she's like, come, come. I put some food for you. Eat it and go. Come. Secretly you come, she called him. And he thought, okay, they all said go. And why is this lady still calling me? He thought for a minute. He thought, okay, if I have to travel from here and go to another place where I can stay and learn about Bible. Okay, 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 okay.
Ma'am, I know, ma'am, I know.
Okay, 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 okay. Okay, and then she thought, and Sundar Singh thought, okay, if I have to take a long journey, 30 miles away from here to go to that place and learn about Jesus and stay there, then I need to walk for a long time, okay? Seth, how does it feel when you have to walk so long? Your legs will pain and then you'll be crying, Amma, I wish I had a bike, somebody carry me, and things like that, no? Okay, and so I will close at this place that, you know, he had to walk a long way. So he thought in his mind, okay, now that my sister-in-law is calling me, I will just go. She was signaling, no, in the dark, come, eat food and go. So he thought, okay, I'll just go, eat and leave from this place. And when he went there, he took the plate. He ate all the food and he started traveling. He went, traveled. 30 miles he traveled. And you know where he reached, children? He reached a place called, because remember, always remember, from Rampur, he went to a place called Rupar. Okay? From Rampur, he went to a place called Rupar. There he met a pastor. His name was Uppal. Okay? His name was Uppal. And when he met Reverend Uppal, he said, hello, knock, knock, in the middle of the night. Sir, can I come into your house? This is how they cast me away from my home. My mom and my brother passed away a long time ago. My father and my uncles and everybody, they treated me so bad and they asked me to get out of the home if I believed in Jesus. But you know, sir, what kept me going? Because I remember the verse in the Bible. It says, anyone who loves his father and mother more than me is not worthy of me. Okay, remember this, everybody. What did he remember from the Bible? Anyone who loves his father and mother more than me is not worthy of me. I remembered this. And that is why I wanted to follow Jesus. And I came so far. He said all these things. And suddenly he collapsed. Suddenly he said, it's paining. Suddenly he started bleeding from his nose, bleeding from his mouth.
I know.
And nobody understood. Oh my, what's going to happen? He's bleeding. Is he going to die? And immediately he called a person there. You know, he's called a compounder, okay? A person who treats patients, who sees the sick people. And he came running and he said, what is this? This man is bleeding from his nose and from his mouth. He's in a bad condition. I wonder if he will even survive this night. Sir, I am sorry, he is going to die. And at this point,
he didn't die.
Sundar Singh asked the pastor to read. Can you please read Mark chapter, last chapter, because I'm going to die. I want you to read Bible for me before I die. But then he read the Bible. He closed his eyes. Everything was quiet. But then in the morning, that person returned to see the dead man, the compounder. He returned to see Sundar Singh dead. And he came and he saw Sundar Singh opening his eyes. And he was like, it's a miracle. How did he live? How did he survive? That was a severe food poisoning. What happened? There, when that lady invited him to eat, she put poison in the food so that he could die. Why? Because he believed in Jesus. But who saved Sundar Singh? Jesus. What a miracle it was. Because God had a big plan for his life. And that is why he preserved his life. He saved him from dying. Isn't that wonderful, children? So all of us, we need to remember that Jesus has a big plan for each one of our lives, and he will save and protect us. But one thing we need to learn is we need to have a great desire like Sundar Singh in our hearts. If we have a desire, what did we learn? Psalm 107 and verse 9, that he satisfies the longing soul and he feeds the hungry soul with goodness. That's right. So today we will continue the story the next time. But until then, shall we close our eyes and make a small word of prayer? Shall we all close our eyes? Okay, I request all of you to close your eyes and let us make a small prayer and say, Lord, see, Sundar Singh used to wake up at 3 a.m. He used to take a shower and pray and then have his breakfast. So Lord, will you please help me to wake up early and pray? Teach me to pray, Lord. Okay, children, can we pray that everybody? Joel and Nathan and Sarah and Priscilla and Josh, Finehas, Abigail, Ruth, and okay, all of us, let us pray in our hearts. And I request Abigail and Josh to pray, and then we will close. Okay, can you make small word of prayers from the lesson that we learned today of Sadhu Sundar Singh? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for this wonderful day. So many of us are not from a Hindu family and have the freedom to worship you and talk about and gave them to you, a Lord. But Sadhu, he was from a Hindu family, still he believed in you and he kept on, O Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father, that you gave us the freedom and you would reveal yourself to many who do not know you, who didn't even know there's a God like you. Thank you that we had the freedom and liberty to be Christians, and that there was a true God who would answer and save us. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross for us. Because if you haven't died on the cross, we would have all gone to hell and we would have been bad, sinful children of you, O Lord. Lord Jesus, thank you for your sacrifice on the cross. Thank you for giving your only Son. We would not have done such a thing, Lord Jesus, but you gave your dear Son. So Lord Jesus, help us to be good children and follow your name and teach the gospel to others, because you have given us the freedom and liberty. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name I say, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
George, he does in prayer too.
Father, thank you for this day, O Lord. Thank you for giving us a nice day, O Lord. Thank you for helping us to learn about Sadhu Singh, O Lord. As he was a sick, O Lord, you helped him to be a Christian and you helped him to know about you, O Lord. You saved his life when he was even going to die, O Lord. You, even though he was very bad and was persecuting you, O Lord, you gave him the truth and made him know the truth, O Lord. Lord, thank you for dying for us on the cross, O Lord, to wash away all our sins, O Lord. Lord, help us to also be like Sadhu Sundar Singh, O Lord. Lord, thank you for giving us the freedom to read the Bible and pray to you, O Lord. Lord, Lord, help us to have the heart like Sundar Singh had to know more about you and to follow you, O Lord. Lord, help us to be like Sadhu Sundar Singh and help us to know more about you, O Lord. Lord, help us to learn more about Sadhu Sundar's life and please talk to us, O Lord. Lord, in Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much, everybody. I believe that you will remember all that we learned. We will continue our lesson maybe the next time, okay? It was nice spending time with you. Bye bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye.
Don't hang up. Joel can open
up. Bye bye, Abigail, man.
Bye, ma'am.
Josh, Finehas, Sarah, Joel. Bye, Joel. Seth, Sarah, Finehas. Bye bye, Nathan, Seth. Have a good time.
Good night.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye. Psalm 107, verse 6, okay?
Yes, 7, verse 7, 9, ma'am.
Oh, I'm sorry, verse 9. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, ma'am.
Bye, Ruth, ma'am.
She left.
Yeah. Don't
let her. Ma'am, is here the report.
Oh, no.
Tell me, ma'am, unmute yourself.
Oh.
Get in mute, ma'am.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just a second, my dear. Let me take the report.
You're on mute. How I can hear you?
Yes, you're in mute, but we can still hear you.
Yeah.
This is another computer.
What a magic. What a magic.
Yeah.
What a magic.
It's a magic.
Can you see? I think there's any other device who is unmuted.
Do you need phone to talk and her laptop to share the report to her phone to talk?
So
the laptop is a hard one.
Oh, now I understand what is
that's the voice. Okay, children. Good afternoon, all.
Good afternoon, ma'am.